Several years ago in India, I think it was a conference arranged by either the Hindustan Times or India Today, I don't remember exactly, but it was at least 10 years ago. I made the statement that evolution is guided by consciousness. And it got me into a lot of trouble. A lot of evolutionary biologists attacked me, including the eminent Richard Dawkins, who's been, an antagonist to my views for a long time, but also others, including people in the media, journalists, etc. To clarify a little bit, I wasn't proposing anything really original. I was going back to the insights of the Vedic rishis and one statement, Sat Chit Ananda. And Sat Chit Ananda is a Vedic axiom, aphorism, sutra, however, Mahavakya, however you want to term it. And in consciousness research, as we think of it, in Eastern wisdom traditions, these axioms are almost like equations, except they're statements. And if you ponder on them, then they reveal some truth. So sat means existence, chit means awareness, and ananda is timeless peace, or timeless joy, or timeless bliss. So let's dissect this equation a little bit, or this aphorism. Sat is existence, chit awareness. So existence and awareness go together, right? Because if there's no awareness of existence, then there's no experience of existence. Well, however you frame the experience in terms of quantum mechanics or mathematics or whatever, but if there is no awareness of existence, then existence is not available. Okay, so the two go together. Existence, awareness of existence. They are in fact fundamentally the same. Awareness is the basis of the experience of existence. Okay, ananda is the joy that comes from this revelation, if we can live it, if we can live it. So all this stuff is actually covered in my book, Quantum Body, and it is co-written with Jack Dzinski, quantum physicist and quantum biologist, and Brian Fertig, who's a neuroendocrinologist and very interested in quantum mechanics, as I am, and he's also an authority on quantum metabolism. So the book addresses all these things. In fact, some of the chapters include: is quantum metabolism the key to disease? What if aging is a mistake? What is the fitness landscape? The importance of the Goldilocks zone as applied to biology, and who's mining the store, etc., etc. Why you aren't a hurricane? Your brain's most important relationship is not you, the wisdom of the body, and the big takeaways that address quantum consciousness as the fundamental ground of all existence. So this morning when I woke up, I had an email from a friend of mine, Neil Thies. Neil Thies is a pathologist, MD, in New York at an academic institution. And he and I are good friends, and he's written a book on complexity theory, which is masterful. And this email sent me a link to something called the Quantum Master Equation. So I went online and I looked up what the Quantum Master Equation is. So here, let me just read to you what I found online. A Quantum Master Equation is a differential equation that describes the time evolution of the density matrix of a quantum system that is interacting with an environment. The density matrix is a mathematical object that describes the state of a quantum system, and its evolution is governed by the Schrödinger equation. Schrödinger, all the way. However, and you know, Schrödinger believed in consciousness, in quantum consciousness, even though he didn't phrase it that way. However, when a quantum system is interacting with an environment, the Schrödinger equation is not sufficient to describe the dynamics of the system. This is because the environment can cause the system to decohere or lose its quantum coherence. The quantum master equation takes into account the effects of decoherence by including a term that describes the interaction between the system and the environment. The term is typically called the Lindblad term, and it is responsible for the decay of off-diagonal elements of the density matrix. The off-diagonal elements of the density matrix represent quantum coherence, so their decay corresponds to the loss of quantum coherence. The quantum master equation can be used to describe a wide variety of phenomena in quantum mechanics, such as relaxation, the decay of excited states to lower states, the decoherence, the loss of quantum coherence, quantum transport, the movement of energy or particles through a quantum system, open quantum systems that are interacting with an environment. The quantum master equation is a powerful tool for studying the dynamics of quantum systems. It is used in a wide variety of fields, including quantum optics, quantum information processing, and quantum chemistry. And then there's more information on this. But as I understand this, I went a little further to see if this quantum equation, master equation, has anything to do with what we call evolution, cosmic evolution, and also the evolution of species. And again, on my research from the internet, I found the following. Physicists have discovered a new law of evolution that governs the behavior of quantum mechanics. The law, which is called the quantum master equation, describes how quantum systems change over time. The law is based on the idea that quantum systems are constantly interacting with their environment. These interactions cause the quantum system to lose information about its initial state. The loss of information leads to the evolution of the quantum system. The quantum master equation can be used to predict the behavior of a wide variety of quantum systems, including atoms, molecules, and even entire galaxies. The discovery of the quantum master equation suggests that cosmic evolution may be occurring at a quantum level. This is because the law applies to all quantum systems, regardless of their size or complexity. As a result, it is possible that the same law is governing the evolution of the universe as a whole. However, it is important to note that the quantum master equation does not provide a complete explanation of quantum evolution. And I'll tell you why in a moment. I'm really excited about this. The law only describes how quantum systems change over time. It does not say anything about the underlying causes of these changes. As a result, it is not clear whether or not cosmic evolution is actually occurring at a quantum level. Overall, the discovery of the quantum master equation is a significant advance in our understanding of quantum mechanics. The law has the potential to revolutionize our understanding of how quantum systems behave and how they evolve over time. So, you know, what was left out in all that was that even this theory implies a subject-object split. There's biological organisms, and then there is their corresponding environment. But what if biological organism and the corresponding environment are actually entangled in a non-local awareness, in a non-local consciousness? So the idea of biological organism and its corresponding environment is based on a flaw, and that flaw is subject-object split. Reality is one wholeness, a unified process, and that unified process is in a deeper domain that transcends both the organism and its quantum origin, and the environment and its quantum origin. They're actually one process. And in that one process, there are many subsets of processes because each biological organism and its so-called environment functions as a whole, as a unified process. So this quantum master equation, if we take it a little further, in that it suggests a quantum consciousness, a non-local awareness, where so-called organism and environment co-evolve as a unified process, then we have solved the mystery of existence, which is Sat Chit Ananda, existence, awareness of existence, and the profound peace and joy that comes from this revelation is a good summary of everything. Sat Chit Ananda is taking the master quantum equation to its final distillation, which is that as non-local awareness, you are the universe. You are the universe as non-local awareness. And in you, the universe evolves, arises, subsides, and recycles and evolves in an eternal now. And you are that. Sat Chit Ananda is also Tattvamasi. If we understand the implications of this, then we will realize that all subject-object is an artificial split as a result of the conditioned mind. It doesn't matter if the conditioned mind is scientific, philosophical, or even religious. And that basic fundamental mistake of our intellect is responsible for all the chaos in the world, all the wars in the world, all the economic and social injustice in the world, and a climate that we are creating, which doesn't understand that biological organism and the biosphere are one. Biosphere here, biosphere universal are one. Think about this and let me know your thoughts, your feedback. And once again, I encourage you to please go on Chopra Foundation Institute, CFI.choprafoundation.org, to take advantage of two courses, The Soul of Leadership and Peace is the Way. And I encourage you to become a peace facilitator, a certified peace facilitator, a certification coming from the foundation, but also to become a certified soul of leadership influencer. How's that? Please join us and let's together create a more peaceful, just, sustainable, healthier, and joyful world.